My name is Dr. V.R. Manoj,
and I welcome you all to my talk on transgeomorphism. And first of all, I would like to extend my sincere respect to Professor Silvan Heino for giving this opportunity, and to all my teachers. They're all my teachers here, because I think it's after a period of more than 18 years that I am standing in front of you. We all met in TRP6. Okay, and I was a kid, and now we meet like this. So it's a very good honor. And this is a concept that myself and Professor Mikael Motelica from University of Orleans, France, we have developed this particular concept, and we want to explain it to you. We want to introduce it to this particular forum, and then we'll be developing this idea from there. That is the concept. Now, I can talk a lot, but you must understand what I'm trying to talk to you about. So I would like to request, that's why I asked the students to come to the front. I am going to ask you a question now. What is SDG? From what you learned today, somebody tell me what is the full form for SDG?
Sustainable development goals.
Good. That answer. Sustainable development goals. Okay, fine. In that, what is sustainability? How many of you understood what is sustainability? You are an IT student, Makana. Just now you wrote my certificate. What is sustainability? Okay, fine, very good. Sustainability. Okay, where did you have your lunch? Can you tell me the name of the place where you had your lunch? What is the name of the mess? So, Jubilee mess is sustainable or non-sustainable? It's a sustainable place, because it has been here for several years, and it is going to be here for several years for future generations to eat their lunch. So it's a sustainable design, it's a sustainable place. So that is the meaning of sustainability. So when such a place has been developed, that is the meaning of sustainable development. Right? So I hope you young minds, you have understood what is sustainability and why we should have it as a goal in whatever we do. Because you are not biologists like me, or you are not philosophers, you are engineers. And why should such a forum come to an engineering college, and why should we go on talking from the morning? This is not a new conversation. There is another hidden force here, Dr. Jaipal Azaria, okay, who has introduced this concept here, and all of these people have developed bioethics in India. They are the fathers of bioethics. And there is a particular reason why this particular concept is here as an engineer. Whenever you do any engineering practice, you should appear or approach it with a sustainable goal. So that is transgeomorphism. So transgeomorphism, the concept, what I am going to tell you is, I will ask you another question. Please forgive me for coming to the ground. What did you have for lunch? Ma'am, what did you have for lunch? I'm so sorry.
I had chapati.
You had chapatis. Sir, what did you have?
Rice.
Somebody had rice, somebody had rasam, somebody had sambar. But it does not matter, because at the end of the day, it is only carbon, hydrogen, nitrogen, oxygen, phosphorus, sulfur. Okay? Whether you eat rice, chapati, rasam, whatever you eat, ultimately only those chemicals are going to be processed by your body, and those some other chemicals are going to be released by your body. So two things are very certain, whether it is ethics or whether it is any other subject. As far as the environment is concerned, nature does not care about you. It simply does not care about you. Okay, this we have to clearly put it in our mind. For nature, you don't matter. You are just a chemical. You are an aggregation of a few chemicals put into the form of a body. That's it. But ultimately, this body has to be returned back to the environment. Whatever you accumulate, whether it is carbon, hydrogen, whether it is air, air is correct and it is a protein. This you will have to give back. Your flesh, your bone, everything, calcium, hydrogen, oxygen, you have to give back. Either you will be buried or you will be burnt. But you turn into a chemical and you will have to give back. And from what is given back, you are taking again and assimilating into a new body. This cycle will go on. This is environmentalism. So please understand environmentalism very, very clearly, or environmental ethics, in a very, very scientific manner. No more are we in an age when we can say, I will change my lifestyle. From tomorrow I will not carry the plastic bag. I will not eat non-vegetarian food. No, it is too late. It's gone. point has gone. You, the younger generation, for the few people who are sitting here, please understand that the tipping point is gone, and now it is time to understand that this change is inevitable. The change to the environment is inevitable, and that is why you can see all these structures. If you put plastic bag inside, there will be a layer of plastic inside. Soon, Copper Age, Bronze Age, Holocene, Anthropocene, all of these scenes are there. Now I am suggesting a new word to you, transgeomorphism. In transgeomorphism, the philosophy clearly states that this change is inevitable. You cannot do anything about it. Then, how do we manage it? Or are we trying to manage it? That is the important thought here. So, you should understand, there are two aspects to environmental ethics. Professor Panveer Selvam, sir, was explaining about anthropocentric, ecocentric, cosmocentric. Have you understood what it is? When you put you in the center, everything is for you. For you only this auditorium, for you only this mic, for you only everything. Then it is anthropocentric. What is ecocentric? You say that nature is at the center and you are coming towards nature. That is ecocentric. Okay? But now, the penultimate lesson that I want to tell again and again is only one thing. Whether it is only your output, or it is only you who are watching nature as anthropocentric or ecocentric. To nature, you don't matter. You are just a chemical. And you are going to come back to nature, whether you burn carbon, whether you are riding in a SUV, or whether you ride a cycle, it does not matter to nature. Nature is neutral. For nature, ultimate thing is, you are going to come back to nature. Even if the carbon levels rise, it's going to happen to nature, it's not going to happen to you. So, from this, why does this person keep on telling this again and again right from the beginning of his speech? Am I trying to impress you? No, I'm not trying to impress you. What I'm trying to impress on you is that the change is necessary for your survival, not for the survival of nature. The planet is going to exist. It is going to be governed by the laws of the solar system. It is going to be there in the same galaxy. It may disintegrate with the burning of the sun. But if you as a species, a human species, Homo sapiens, this species, if it has to survive in this planet, how should it survive? You engineers should answer this question. So because earlier it used to be only bioethics. I was introduced to bioethics in the year 1999. That time HIV/AIDS was the biggest bioethical problem. Now, environmental problems are the greatest problems. But the purpose of ethics has been the same, the importance of value, the integrity. If you are not having, I have prepared several slides, see. How, what are the real problems, population, GDP. All of these have been told from the morning to the evening, but how much have you listened? That is more important. This is desertification. What can we do about it? Desertification. Desertification means, it is scientifically understood, the rate of evaporation is higher than the rate of rainfall. Then you end up with a desert. How do you reverse that? Engineering is being done there. Ecological engineering. They are relaying it with the trees. So that it is again growing. The desert will become an oasis. These things we can do. What are the two pictures in front of you? Up and down. In the top, what is naturally happening? What should naturally happen? The natural process of the earth. Creation and destruction are part and parcel of nature. We go to temples, we go to gurudwaras, we go to churches and we repeat the same thing. But this is the natural process. It goes on. Look at the bottom one. These are the changes that we have introduced. These changes cannot be reversed. Okay, we are past the tipping point. So this is my transgeomorphism. So through transgeomorphism, we are going to attempt to study it in a scientific manner, how the, you have already seen this magazine covers, warning, giving warning about the potential part of the earth. Now, the relationship between transgeomorphism and bioethics is central as it directly addresses the rights of humans and all living beings to live with dignity in a constantly changing anthropogenically dominated. dominated environment. Lot of English words put together to form a sentence, but have you understood what it is? What is meant by right to dignity? What is the temperature of this room? Is it normal? Are you supposed to be in a room like this? What is the core body temperature? See, everything is numbers, facts, data. Okay? So what is the core body temperature? Your core body temperature is 37 degrees Celsius. I put a thermometer inside your body through any orifice, the temperature is going to be 37 degrees Celsius. This is common. If you are a human being, the temperature will be that. If you are a snake, then it will not be there. Okay? So this temperature is constant. And you are supposed to be in an environment which is conducive to that environment. Where we were for the lunch, the sustainable building, the jubilee mess. That is in coherence with your body temperature. So these are the kinds of changes that we must analyze. Whether the kind of environment, because for this AC room to function from morning to evening, electricity is coming from this place. I will show you the place. From the bottom, those dinosaurs have converted themselves into hydrocarbons. That hydrocarbon has been extracted as oil. It is burnt somewhere. Coal or oil is burnt somewhere. Runs a generator, engineering. So that is where you see the measure of the energy that you are going to use. Are you going to extract your energy for running a seminar hall using electricity from a fossil fuel? Is it ethical? Okay. So here the meaning of the word ethical reaches a new dimension. It is no longer the old concept of ethics where right and wrong. No, we are in the wrong only now. You have to accept it. So the conclusion will be, thank you. But before that, I would request all of you to not to underestimate Mother Nature. Okay? Mother Nature should not be underestimated. She is on her way back. So this transgeomorphism, this concept I am introducing into this seminar with a lot of respect, because this we are going to study in depth and we are going to develop certain rubrics. Rubrics means you write your unit test, midterm test, no? You write or not? In that you get 5 marks, 10 marks. At the end of the semester, your teacher will say, you have got 5 marks, 10 marks, eh? So you are likely to fail in the university exam. Or you are going to get pass mark. So this rubrics we need to understand very, very seriously. How much more time we have. We are already cancer patients. Okay? Just we have to calculate how much more time we have. It is not possible. I am not a doomsday cultist. I am not here to tell you that doomsday is coming, correct? Come. But the earth is going to change. There is nothing you can do about it. But we can try to understand the changes so that we can take some steps to survive as a species. So survival as a species is more important, not saving the environment. Saving the environment is automatic. But you, if you want to be a human being, because if you disappear as a species, the cockroaches are going to survive. See, for in our biotechnology lab, where we use a polymerase chain reaction, where we use an enzyme called TAC polymerase that is obtained from a bacteria called Thermus aquaticus. It can survive at a temperature of more than 100 degrees Celsius. No problem. But you touch a small pot of water, which is a little higher than 10 degrees Celsius. Okay? So, there are species which are ready to take your place. So, if you want to survive, please try to understand it from a scientific point of view. From the engineering point of view, whatever engineering products you develop, whatever software you develop, coding you develop, whatever structures you build, make it sustainable, make it eco-friendly, because this is the primary reason. And we as ethicists, we are studying it. So please take heed to our lesson. And I would like to thank my professor, Subramanian sir and team for the opportunity. I would like to thank Professor Darrell Messer for the opportunity. And I would like to give my sincere reverence to my bioethics guru, late Professor Dr. Jaipal Acharya. Okay? Thank you very much.